Dobrý den.
Ciao.
With this video, we will start the saga of learning about the 14 paradigms of Czech noun declension. Let's have a look on the paradigms of Czech masculine.
Paradigms.
The Czech masculine animate and inanimate. No, this is definitely not a blbost. What's the plan? Some of you asked about declensions, and I'm very happy you did, because declensions are the main characteristic, the main difficulty, and the most important skill to learn for students in Czech language. So we shall start our training for the art of declension today. First nouns, later verbs, and the rest will come smoothly because we will understand the principles. So what a paradigm is? In the traditional grammar of Latin, Greek, and other inflected languages, it was the table of all the inflected forms, serving as a model, as a pattern. The paradigm of nominal declension depends on the gender and the ending in the nominative case of the noun. So, masculine first. So first, masculine animate. Second, masculine inanimate. In my school years, 200 years ago, there were only two paradigms of masculine animate. Pan, muž. Today, there are five of them. The masculine rules more than ever. Pan. Pan. Muž, muž, předseda, předseda, mind the pronunciation, muž with an š, předseda, we are not pronouncing předseda, předseda, soudce, soudce, and mluvčí. Mluvčí. Take them for what they are. Prototypes, types, examples. Like, for example, Hippocrates and Galen, who dispatched human temperaments into four groups. Sanguine, choleric, melancholic, and phlegmatic temperaments. Okay. So what is the magic here? What and the logic? All the Czech nouns, all the Czech masculine animate nouns should fit into one of these five types. For example, the noun host, host, belongs into the category of pan. Why? Because both finish with a hard consonant, host T and pan N. For memory, H, H, K, R, D, T, N are hard consonants. For hard, soft and undetermined consonants, please see the video about Czech phonemes. The noun kůň fits into the group of muž. Both finish with a soft consonant. For memory, ž, š, č, ř, ř, d, t, ň are soft consonants. The noun sluha, sluha, fits into the category of předseda. Both finish with an a. Vládce belongs into the group of soudce. Both finish with e. Rozhodčí belongs into the category of mluvčí. Both finish with e. So it's quite simple. ended. And logical and predictable. Predictability is very important in learning. And Czech nouns behave with a fair amount of predictability. Some exceptions occur, of course, but exception always confirms the rule, and we have just learned the rule. What we will do with this knowledge? We will use it in the current Czech speech inflected by the seven cases. That's why we are learning them. We need to know how the nouns will behave when we will apply the inflection. And there are seven cases, so it should seem quite a lot to learn, but precisely if we have the paradigms, it will be easier, much more easier. What we can observe? That only two of them end in a consonant. Pán with a hard consonant N and muž with a soft consonant Ž. Even if you pronounce Sh, we can hear Sh. The Ž, we'll get it back when we, for example, when we use a diminutive for muž, mužík, mužíček. Here we again pronounce and hear the Ž. Or mužatka, mužný, we have the Ž back. Předseda finishes with a vowel A, which is quite rare. It's the main characteristic of feminine nouns. By the way, in feminine and neuter, we will not distinguish animate and inanimate. It's just simplification. Soudce finishes with a vowel E and mluvčí with a vowel I. Exercise. Into which category belongs kluk? Kluk finishes with a hard consonant K, so it will belong into the group of pán, finishes with the hard consonant N. Gymnasta will belong into the group of předseda, finishes with A, like předseda. Průvodčí into the category of mluvčí. Král, L is an ambiguous consonant. It will belong into the group of muž. So they are all animate. Bůh into the category of pán. So to go further into this initiation, let's have a look on the masculine inanimate nouns. Hrad ends with the hard consonant D, and stroj. Stroj ends with a J, which is a soft consonant. Exercise. Into which category belongs the noun less? So again here we have S, which is an ambiguous consonant. It can be hard or soft. So here it will be assimilated with the hard consonant, hrad. Stupeň, ending with a soft consonant ň, belongs into the group of stroj. Zámek ends with k, belongs into the group of hrad. So, let's resume. The paradigms for masculine animate and inanimate nouns. Masculine animate. Pán, muž, předseda, soudce, mluvčí, and hrad, stroj, are the paradigms for masculine inanimate. So I believe it's quite easy. I hope you will not be bored. I wish you success, and when I see you the next time, we'll have a look on the feminine paradigms. Brzy naschledanou.